And Michaela joins me from London. Well, Michaela, how did it feel to be one of the stars of the show?
It's amazing. We've had an incredible day here in London. We've been running up and down Whitehall Street most of the day, but it's been an absolute buzz and an honour to have spoken to the Prime Minister and to be recognised in that way. And I mean, not only myself, but all the people that I work with.
What did the Prime Minister say to you?
He actually asked the group of people if anyone had done any crazy, in his words, fundraising. And the wrong answer, so I thought I would. And so they told him about the marathon that I did back in June. And he asked how much that had raised, and I told him that last week we went over 5,000. So, yeah, he was really interested in how the marathon came about and where I did it and how I launched it. So it was a good 2 or 3 minute chat with the Prime Minister, and he seemed really receptive to that, which was encouraging for me.
You must be very aware then of the work that you're doing in raising awareness regarding spinal muscular atrophy.
Yeah, I think spinal muscular atrophy is one of many, many neuromuscular conditions that affect over 2,000 people in Northern Ireland and over 75,000 people in the entire of the UK. So it's really important for me to make sure that they are at the centre of what I do. I couldn't do anything that I've done without the support of family back home and family here with me in London, as well as the support of the charity at the Muscular Dystrophy UK, and they always provide support as well. So, you know, whether I'm working with a muscle line or whether I'm working with trailblazers or whether I'm like fundraising, it doesn't really matter. You know, I've got a lot of support behind me, and today really cemented the fact that we are doing the right thing, that I am doing the right thing, and that we are moving society forwards, slowly but surely, but we are getting there.
You didn't lean on the Prime Minister to make more money available, did you?
If I had the opportunity earlier, I absolutely think that you know, just by meeting him today, he will have a slightly different view of what's possible when you're in a wheelchair, or use a wheelchair, as I would say. So hopefully even that will have had an impression. Maybe, who knows, we might get a lot of it more investment on a few less cuts, maybe. But it's definitely been a really encouraging day for all of us here in Northern Ireland. And hopefully here in London we'll be able to keep pushing up and forward and keep getting better and keep moving society forward, because that's really important for us all.
It wouldn't be like you not to make use of an opportunity like today's. Michaela, congratulations again, and thanks for talking to us tonight.